Mr. Barnett, are you employed at Hoosier Cook's gas station on Old Stoneman Highway?
No, sir. I am the owner.
The owner?
Mr. Cook had a stroke. I bought the station from him. I got his permission to keep the name.
A self-sufficient businessman. And the reason for retaining the name?
White folks don't much like putting money into a colored man's pocket, even if I do give the most complete tune-up service in the county and at the best price.
Tell the court about the night of October 21st.
Well, they came hauling in around 9 o'clock. That gentleman there behind the wheel, honking, laughing, making all kind of fuss. I tried to tell him I was closed, but he says, fill it, clean the shield, and make it damn snappy. The man in the back seat, Mr. Cooper, was playing around with the shotgun, aiming it at pretend ducks.
So you serviced the car, despite the fact that you were closed?
They smelled like a brewery. They did not strike me as being friends of my race.
Your Honor,
have your witness simply state the facts.
Was anyone else in the car?
That man there, first row, blue shirt. He was riding up front, passenger side.
Let the record show that the witness has identified Jerry Blount. So, although the two defendants claimed to have been out purely joyriding alone that night, your testimony places Jerry Blount in the car with them. Why the discrepancy, do you suppose? Is it because Jerry Blount also testified that he saw Kyle Cooper aim the shotgun, pull the trigger, and kill Colonel Eugene Landis, while Mr. Plaquemines maneuvered the car into position?
Objection, Your Honor. Unless I'm mistaken, summation occurs at the end of a trial.
Knoxville is now boarding on track 3. The express to Knoxville. Stop. Jackson.
Good day, sir.
Now boarding on track 3.
Good day, ma'am.
Thank you.
Forward, please.
Hey, yeah, sir. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Every time I see your face, I wonder how it is I could have ever gotten on this train and gone.
Joe, this is John Morgan. John Morgan, this is my friend Joe.
Do you really get to ride on this train all day?
Indeed I do. It's my job.
John Morgan took the Washingtonian to visit his cousins up north, or so he told me 5 times on the way over.
And when I was looking out the window, I saw some robbers on the side of the road, but the train kept going.
Let me ask you a question, Lefty. Would you like to see the engine compartment?
Yes, sir!
Well, then come on. Let's go. Mind if a friend has a look around?
No, come on up.
Mr. Gibbs, monitor every part of the train from here. All speed, pressure, air conditioning, fuel. These gauges tell them everything.
Neat.
Go ahead, hop on up. Careful.
You in town for long?
Not near long enough to do all that I want.
That's some kind of big list.
Be around long enough to do most what I like.
Woo-hoo! Joe, Lily's only ridden on locals, not expresses like me.
Doesn't take an economist to figure out why.
You can ride my rail anytime you want.
There's a car on the track. Look out. I can't stop it. Woo! Look out.
Has the jury reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor. We find the defendant, Kyle Longmore Cooper, guilty as charged. We find the defendant, Guildford I. Plaquemine, guilty as charged.
Mr. Plaquemine and Mr. Cooper will be remanded to the custody of the federal marshal. We will gather a week from Friday for sentencing. These proceedings are adjourned.
Damn fine job, Forrest.
Thank you, Trucks. You did a great job.
There it is. You did it.
Appreciate your help, Brad.
Back at UVA, we used to call you Yard Dog. You always were unstoppable, stubbornest man I ever met.
Thanks, Nick.
To be honest, I never thought we'd see this day.
Well, there were some mixed signals there for a while.
Anything from Washington yet?
Brad, the jury just gave the verdict a half a minute ago. You ever coach Little League?
Beg your pardon?
About 7, 8 years ago?
One summer. For my oldest boy.
Yeah. It's been bugging me since I first saw you. I coached 1 year for Hatfield. We played you. We won. We shook hands after. You said, good game, coach.
I delivered for Vincent's florist at Christmas.
Oh, the poinsettias for Mom's class.
Right.
Yeah.
You're just now going home from school?
Actually, I was at the main library, because our branch has mostly outdated books.
And Mr. Davenport's report is due. The tough grader.
I thought the deadline was Friday.
So, where are you off to?
I'm just riding around. That's 650cc. Board out to about 705. Quarter mile in about 14 seconds. You want to ride home?
Oh, I don't think so.
Come on, it's okay. It's stupid to have to walk 2 miles if you don't have to.
Drop me off on a corner of Minyard and Old Town Road.
All right, hold on.
License and registration. I clocked you doing 60 miles an hour.
in a 45 zone. What is your passenger's name?
Claudia Bishop. He was just giving me a ride to Kenshaw.
What is your passenger's name?
Claudia Bishop.
And where were you and your passenger going?
She just told you.
Yeah. Now what are these, son?
I don't know.
Look like amphetamines to me.
Those aren't mine. I don't know how they got there, I swear.
Going home, girl. Going home, girl. You are under arrest. For possession of narcotics. Please step to the patrol car.
Those pills weren't mine. I think they caught planted the moment. I don't know how they got there.
How long have you had that motorcycle?
Maybe a month.
Who was the girl?
Friend from school.
Why would a police officer want to plant pills on you?
I don't know. He didn't like what he saw. If you don't believe me.
Why the hell should I believe you? I won't tolerate a liar, Nathan. You lied to me about that motorcycle, kept it behind my back. You deceived me, and you deceive yourself if you think that taking pills is going to solve anything.
I told you, they weren't mine. Fine, whatever. Call me a liar, because you're perfect.
Son, you don't want to lock horns with me over this. I can tell you exactly who's going to end up on top.
Go ahead, Dad, tell me. You think I'm some stupid little kid? I could go into the service if I wanted to. I'm a man.
I know how old you are. That's why I expected more of you. You're not to leave the house unless it's to go to school. And by that, I mean your classes. Wrestling's suspended.
No way.
You're done with that, Nathan. Done with all those things.
Ellie, where's Joe?
I'm sure he'll be here soon.
The Aurora leaves Birmingham at 10:06 and arrives in Brooklyn at 3:14. Joe should be here by now.
Why can't you remember your bedtime like that?
Come on, I've got something to
show you. Let me catch my
breath. I'm a dying quail here. Come on, come on. Be back in a minute.
Look at my new train.
Fine rolling stock you got there, Lefty.
Why do you call me Lefty? I'm not left-handed.
That's the point.
It always does that there.
Coming off a grade like that, centrifugal force is going to derail you every time. Can't ignore ratio and geometric laws.
What are they?
They are complicated. Now, we put this straight piece right in here, and that should fix it.
How did you know so much?
Spent a year laying track. Then I get a peek at the guys that work inside the train. White gloves, smooth uniforms, cool as cucumbers. So now that's the job.
John Morgan, take those plastic houses and cows off the table so I can set places for supper.
But Lily, that's called Pepper Depot.
Lefty, this is for you. Looks like you're gonna need it.
Wow, thanks, Joe.
Whistle at the cold pepper stop.
He's memorized the exact time of every stop you make between New Orleans and Richmond. He couldn't be more impressed with you if you were Casey Jones.
And what about you? Would you prefer to be with Casey Jones? You know he's only 5'3".
For a man who can't dance a lick, you're all right.
Now, come on. Let's not start with that.
You said yourself you wish you were a dancer. That's why I signed us up for mambo lessons at the church social hall.
What?
And you love every minute of it.
Or what? Come on, I just got off the road.
That's right, you have. Tomorrow night, 9 o'clock. Don't be late.
I'll Fly Away. We'll continue after this brief intermission.
Well, quite a program. Welcome back. I'm Richard Steele with Cheryl Hamada. And we're here because this is a very special time for us. This is an unscheduled pledge drive. And we're sorry for breaking into the program, but it is very necessary that we talk to you about this $360,000 that we're trying to raise by June 12th. And to do that, we need your assistance, and we need it right away at 588-1111. Because of the commitment to the kind of program you're watching right now, we need the money that supplies the program. You should know this. Over the last couple of years, the costs for doing the kind of programs that you see here at Channel 11 have increased in excess of $600,000. Just to give you some idea of the expense of running a WTTW and getting the kind of programs you're watching, like the one you're watching right now. 588-1111, our volunteers are here and waiting. Again, we do need your support. $360,000 is no small sum of money. Now, fortunately, the good news is we did pretty well the last time around, and I think we're somewhere around $243,000. And that's not bad, but we have a way to go. And again, if we can do this before the 12th, whenever we accomplish our goal, we stop. But right now, we're not on stop. There's some special things that you can get as thank you gifts if you call now and pledge. Cheryl?
That's right. Of course, with every basic membership, $40 or greater, you're going to receive a year subscription to our 11 magazine, as well as a personalized membership card, and that's good for discounts all across the city. But if you can become a member at a slightly higher level, let's say just $50, maybe you'd like to receive our set of I'll Fly Away coffee mugs. It's a set of two. You can see right there, I'll Fly Away, and it says Quality Soars on Public TV. That is a set of mugs for $50 membership. And for a $75 membership, maybe you'd like to receive our I'll Fly Away t-shirt. And it's kind of a wheat color there, and it comes in extra large, so it'll fit everybody. It'll feel very good. Very good on the outside, and you're also gonna feel very good on the inside, because you're gonna know you help support a program that is of such high quality, that means so much to our community here. And we're so very happy to have given this program an extended lease on life here on PBS. It's possible because of member dollars. The dollars here keep us strong. They give us the ability to have some control. I mean, how many times have you had a favorite TV show disappear from the networks and there's not much you can do? Here, you have some control. How? With your phone calls and your financial support. So go to the telephone right now.
Cheryl, and speaking of being financial and supportive, what we need to do here is, if you can kind of put this in a business reference, WTTW would like to make sure that we are fiscally responsible. And in order to do that, by the end of the year, which is June 30th, we must be within that fiscal guideline. And so by that point, we must be in the black. That's why this is so important, because we're not quite at that. Unfortunately, pledge drives have not reached the level that we would have liked them to in the past. It's been a tough year. So now's the time we need to make up for that. So we have to do it now during this period. And as again, as we said before, we have until June 12th. But if we reach that goal before the 12th, then we can cease from doing the pledge drive. But right now we're into it, and we sure do need your calls at 588-1111, 588-1111. One of the things we're committed to here at Channel 11 is good programming, and we're committed to different points of view. We're not squeamish about showing things that represent a point of view that perhaps is not even that popular. But that's what makes Channel 11 so different, and one of the reasons why it's so important for you to support what we do, so we can keep that independence, that freedom to bring you the kind of programming that's so necessary. 588-1111, 588-1111. Now, there are some other things you should know about what we're doing.
That's right. And the most important thing, I think, is your role in what we're doing right here. You may not realize that, you know, sometimes you're sitting at home and it's easy to be lulled into a sense of complacency. It feels like free TV. It's really not. As Richard mentioned earlier today, this evening, it costs an incredible amount of money to acquire and broadcast these programs. As he said, over the last 2 years, costs have increased by over $600,000. That's the increase. And it's very expensive. Of course, $360,000 is not a huge amount. It's a lot of money, but in terms of what it costs to broadcast programs, it's not that giant amount. We can do it. You have an active role, a very important role in helping us reach that goal with your phone calls. If you are enjoying the programs right now, if you are one of the select audience, not the masses who rejected it on network, but one of the select few who recognizes the quality of this program and tunes in and is hooked on this series, and if you're watching right now, I know you are hooked, because you can't watch just one of these episodes. You get invested in the characters and the story. You are a regular viewer. And as a regular viewer, you need to go to the telephone. We need to hear from you right now.
You know, Cheryl, one of the things we watched in I'll Fly Away this last couple of minutes was focused around a train. And that's a good good representation of what we're talking about today. You are the engine that drives this train, and we need to get you to stoke the fires right now, so to speak. 588-1111, we encourage you to become a member at the basic rate of $40. That's okay, and as a matter of fact, whatever you can call and pledge is fine, but $40, you get the member card, and you also get a subscription to 11 Magazine. Now, we encourage you to use your credit card, Visa, MasterCard, or American Express. And if you can use the card, it makes it a whole lot faster. The process sort of kicks into high gear. You can pledge by check. Now, some people think because we talk about credit cards a lot, checks are out. Checks are not. Checks are in, as well as credit cards. So what you should do is make that telephone call right now and show your commitment to Channel 11. The reason you are able to watch And I'll Fly Away, which was on a network television that isn't now, is because people were not committed to it the way we're committed to it here at Channel 11. So call us, become a member, 588-1111. We need your support right now. Now, one of the things we have is kind of a running barometer of how we're looking. And Cheryl, we've got a board over here to our right that kind of tells us what our dollar figure is, and I guess we'll talk about that in a second. 588-1111, 588-1111, give us a call right now. Operators are waiting. They want to take your calls, right?
That's right. We have a nice volume of calls, but you know, I see a lot of people who are still waiting to talk to you, and as Richard mentioned, we do have our pledgeometer, I like to call it, here in the studio. I'll show you right here, and all the way up here is our goal, our ultimate goal, $360,000. That's where we'd like to end up. Right now, we are currently, this is actually a little low, because we're actually at $243,000, so we're closing in on $250,000. Hopefully we can reach that during this break if we can keep the phones going, but ultimately this is where we want to go, and when we reach this goal, we're going to stop the drive and we will go back to the kinds of programming you've counted on, uninterrupted programming here at Channel 11. So do go to the telephone right now. As we've mentioned before, we encourage you to bring your credit card along with you. That way we can rush your premium out to you all the sooner. Also, we can put those dollars to work in programs. I'd like to thank some of the people who are answering our telephones tonight. They volunteered their time. Answering our phones this evening is Harris Trust and Savings Bank, people from there, people from the National Air Traffic Controller Association, people from Sam the Shoe Doctor, and our friends of 11. We'd like to thank them all. Why don't you give yourselves a hand? Thank you for answering the phones for us. Let's put these people to work so they can't applaud a little later, okay? We like it actually when they can't applaud because their hands are too busy holding telephones and pens, taking your pledges of support to the station. We are going back to more of I'll Fly Away, but please go to the telephone and vote for the program before it begins. We'll be staying in the studio during the program just to take your calls, so do call us right now.
Now return to I'll Fly Away.
You sure Underhill said 1?
1 o'clock sharp, gather the troops. That was the message.
This looks bad.
Ever the loyalist, Brad. That's what I like about you.
No other calls, though, or cables from Washington.
Nope. Well, we all know Bobby wanted this thing slowed down.
Truth is, Forrest, you countermanded an order.
I thought you were pleased with the verdict.
I am.
Forrest, don't you think it's smarter if you deal with Underhill alone? He might think this is confrontational. Look, I'm just talking strategy here.
Yes? Send him in. He's here.
Jim?
Gentlemen.
Sir.
Hello, Jim.
Richmond, Virginia newspaper straw poll indicates popular support of the verdict. Phone calls and telegrams to the White House aren't that many, but they're trending favorable. I'm handling the local press, and we'll see how that goes. Gentlemen, we may have ourselves a winner here.
Would I be overeager if I concluded those are congratulatory telegrams?
Indeed they are. I filched this one for you. It's to Bobby from Bag Hammarskjöld. Hope you know a good framer.
Some libations would do right about now, wouldn't they, gentlemen?
Amen.
Brad, would you get some glasses?
Dan?
Didn't mean to let the side down. I live surrounded by snakes up there in Washington. Brad Duncans of the world running rampant all over the place. This is a proud day for all of us.
Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
Even boy, Mr. Johansson mentioned your name in civics class. He said that the Landers case is probably historic, that your name might be in history books.
Well, I wouldn't start erecting any monuments, Francis.
It's great, Dad.
You're practically a star. Even Tony Jonas, he's that cute boy in school, said you were better than E.G. Marshall in Defenders.
Something smells wonderful.
I got some rack of lamb.
I can't remember the last time we had lamb.
I felt something special was in order.
Daddy, Lily snuck out early yesterday.
What's for supper?
Were you studying?
Sleeping.
Nice the way you said congratulations to Dad.
Do you want to hear my congratulations?
If you're up to it.
Daddy, Lily snuck out early yesterday by a whole hour.
John Morgan, I heard you. I know she left early. Why are you telling me this?
Because tattling is a religion for him. He's devoted his life to it. St. John Morgan of the Blessed Squealers. Dad, the news is on in 2 minutes. Can we eat in the den in case you're on TV?
I don't see why not.
I need mayonnaise.
On lamb?
I don't want this anymore.
Why not? You love that hat.
Joe thinks I'm a baby who wears engineer's hats. I'm not some little baby who wears hats. Hats are dumb.
Breaking verdict, a federal jury today found two men guilty of depriving a Negro Air Force officer of his civil rights by murdering him. We're here at the federal courthouse with Justice Department officials.
Turn it up, Francie.
Mr. Underhill, why the sudden interest in prosecuting civil rights cases?
Well, the Justice Department has always maintained a strong stand on the issue of discrimination. It's never wavered, but no one questioned that.
Mr. Larkin, this case was handled by your man in the 5th District. How hands-on was Washington in pursuance of this case?
Day to day, it was a team effort all the way.
Anything you'd like to add to that?
We are proud Americans today, aren't you?
Oh, there you have it. The end of the case.
Dad, they didn't even mention your name.
On a lonely stretch of highway, a Negro man, well-respected, out driving alone.
Horace.
Chief.
Sorry about your boy. His arrest gave me no pleasure.
I'm curious to know what exactly happened, Chief.
At 4:32 p.m., Officer John Sonius apprehended your son driving a Triumph motorcycle down Macon Road, traveling at 15 miles an hour over the limit. During the course of a cursory search, two amphetamine bennies were found in the left pocket of his leather jacket. Don't feel bad. You're not the only father whose child has crossed the line.
I don't understand why I'd do a thing like that.
Read Life magazine. This country is facing an epidemic of juvenile delinquency.
Please, Chief, we're living in a one-horse town, and Nathan is not a juvenile delinquent.
Who knows why? Genes? Something in the family history? Or maybe it's just the way he was brought up.
You aren't letting our past differences get in the way here, are you, Chief?
I forgot.
Because I can't help wondering how those amphetamines came to rest in Nathan's pocket.
Are you implying malfeasance? Should I get a stenographer in here?
What was probable cause for the search?
He made a motion to his pocket as if to throw something away.
Naturally, I'll need to see the arrest report. I'd also like a look at the chain of custody and the lab report.
You know what they say, Forrest. A lawyer who represents himself has a fool for a client.
Naturally, I won't represent Nathan. But if I need to, I can get the dean of Duke Law School to do it. Or don't you think I have access to some of the best legal minds in this country? And that I wouldn't call on my relationships to help my son? They'll tear the roof off this place. They'll go over this case with tweezers, and if they find any improprieties, you'll be lucky to be a crossing guard. How old are you?
You better watch what you say.
Lily, will you watch my puppet show tonight?
I'm afraid I can't, John Morgan.
I have plans this evening.
With Joe?
That's right.
Where are you and Joe going?
Dancing. John Morgan. Joe's my boyfriend. Does that bother you?
No. Did you give him the hat back?
No, I didn't. It's sitting right over there on the table.
I told you to give it back to him.
I think you might regret that decision. That's a fine hat.
I don't want that stupid old hat.
What about hurting Joe's feelings? What about being rude to someone who went out of their way for you? Doesn't that count for anything?
Kissing's disgusting. Yuck.
John Morgan, I think someone's been standing in the wrong doorway. I think someone's been snooping.
Hi.
Hi.
Elements.
In one ear and out the other. It's like trying to memorize hieroglyphics.
Guess you didn't get any of my messages. Your mom's treating me like the other kids in school.
She's been crazed. It's like a zoo at my house. Uncle Chick and Aunt Renee came in from Memphis. You'd think royalty was visiting. I'm sorry.
Listen, I can't go to the Jefferson game bonfire with you this weekend.
Why not? Whole school's gonna be there.
Yeah, well, my dad grounded me. He's giving me a really hard time. You'd think I robbed a bank or something.
You know, everyone's saying you and Claudia Bishop have a thing going.
What?
Is it true?
Is what true?
What they're saying.
Are you crazy?
Then why did you stop and offer her a ride in the first place?
She was there, walking. I don't know.
Nathan, you made a decision. You stopped. You must have been attracted to her.
She's colored.
Well, then you're stupid. And so what if she's colored? When do you think you're going to be able to go out to parties and stuff again?
I don't know.
Yes, it does. Your mom and dad know you're riding the bus, boy?
Uh-huh. I'm supposed to meet them on Oak Street.
Okay. Sonny. Hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing in here?
He hasn't seen him at all, then? I appreciate it, Mrs. Anston. Please call me if he does. Not at Roddy's.
Are you sure that little gnome lies like a rug?
Roddy didn't even go to school today. He's sick. I spoke to John Morgan's teacher. She said he had a very typical day. He was fine at school. Left the usual time.
Maybe he ran away.
Call Lily. She might know something.
I did. She's not home. Has he mentioned anything that's been bothering him?
The only thing he's talked about for the past week are those stupid train schedules.
Maybe I could ride out to the station. I could go out by Cherry Hollow where he keeps that stupid fort. What do you think I'm gonna do? Go to the beach? He's only my brother.
Your car keys are on my dresser. Nancy, you stay by the phone while I look around the neighborhood. Yeah.
you know the basics.
Any luck?
No.
Me either. I looked everywhere I could think of.
Dad, Lily's on the phone. Joe Morgan's in Aikensville. At a church or something. He took a bus there.
What was he trying to prove?
I don't know. Nathan, I don't believe that those drugs ever belonged to you. I shouldn't have doubted your word. But it's difficult. You're so secretive these days, you don't even try to talk to me. And worst of all, you lied to me about that motorcycle.
You wouldn't even listen to me about the motorcycle. You wouldn't even give me a chance. I didn't want to lie about it, but you made me.
I'm sorry you feel that way.
Oh, I do. You know, I thought things would be different between us. When you were seeing Miss Lekatsis, even though I knew you had done it while Mom was still alive and all, I went along. I tried to see it your way.
Just one second.
This happens, and this is the thanks I get.
Nathan, you and I may be many things to one another, but we are not friends. We are not co-equals. Whatever you may think of what I've done, there can be no tit for tat between us, no wink and a deal. Ever. About anything. I would hope that when you look at me, you see more than hypocrisy. I know we have more history than that. You said to me that you're a man. And I as much as agree, but it isn't so. You still have someone to set limits for you, to care for you, to absolve you of your mistakes.
Absolve?
Someone who loves you unconditionally. Adults don't have that. That's my job. And I'm going to continue to do it, no matter what you think of me. I will not back off. Never. Know that now.
Sure you don't want any hot chocolate, Lefty? There's plenty in there.
No.
Well, I'm gonna get some for myself.
Why did you follow me, John Morgan? What am I going to tell your daddy when he gets here? John Morgan.
I didn't finish my eggs this morning, but you just took my plate away anyhow. You used to tell me to do those things, but now you just stopped.
No, I didn't stop. You're getting bigger. I expect you to do some things on your own.
I'm not big.
You told me just the other day you're not a baby.
You said we were friends. You said we would go to Egypt together one day. But you don't even think about me anymore. You think about him.
Yes, I do think about him. But that doesn't mean I can't think about other people, too. You may not believe this, but one day you're going to meet a little girl.
I hate girls. I just like you.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to be around for a long time. So if 10 years pass and you still hate all girls except me and you want us to go to Egypt together, that's just what we'll do.
Without Joe?
Just you, me, and a camel. You got a handkerchief?
No.
Blow your nose.
Hi, Sheila.
Remember the old days of reading O'Callahan? You laid on your couch, you were out the door. I can leave these here.
We're only going across the street to Mario's.
You have a lint dealie somewhere, don't you?
Enid called. She'll pick you up at National. She's bringing Carrie. Apparently, she stayed home sick from school today.
Again? Did Enid congratulate you?
Yes, she did.
Oh, speaking of which,
what's this?
Open the front cover. That's the president's signature, not some secretary's.
Well,
I see you've got the Washington Dispatch.
All right, thinking Americans can sleep better tonight because paradoxically, America herself has awakened from a slumber of indifference. The victory, by all involved, sounds the alarm. Said Special Assistant Nicholas Larkin.
The Navy's called, asked me to inflate a blimp.
No, it's great stuff.
Look, about the press conference the other day.
Nick, come on.
No, really, you were supposed to be notified. Things are always falling through the cracks, damn it. Look, Tim is an old infighter. He knows how to reap the lion's share.
My kids felt bad, Nick. That's all.
Shouldn't have left it with Tim.
You hungry?
As far as that dispatch piece, I did mention you prominently. There's just no way to control what they ultimately print. You know that.
Nick, it's all right. Why did we pick the political arena? Nobody's holding a gun to our head. Where's the loo?
Across the hall.
Use this door. Still want to eat with me?
Mr. Bedford, will you be wanting something to eat?
No, thanks. I caught a bite in town.
Mr. Bedford, it's really good how the Landers trial turned out, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
My brother, he lives in Newark, New Jersey, says it even made the northern papers.
Yes, so I understand.
Mr. Bedford, the people here in my community, we know who brought this case to justice.
I see. Lily? You came to me some time back and brought the Landers case to my attention.
Yes, sir.
I think that was a good thing.
Good night, sir. I always thought my dad would fall in love again and remarry. I never asked, but I thought he wanted it. I tried to introduce him to suitable matches. Suitable to myself, he said. It riled him. He said I was only serving myself. I thought long and hard about it, and he was right. I did meet a woman, though, Mrs. Caldwell. I think he'd like her. I don't see anything wrong with selfishness if everyone benefits.